My name is Jeff Goulet from Lapierre Company. I'm here to show you what we offer for an alternative as a vacuum pump. This is a Bosch vacuum pump. This pump features a water-free, oil-free functioning. It features rotary claws. It's mechanics that turns against each other and that generates vacuum. This pump is directly driven, so motor, and there's a gearbox in between, and the rotary claws are at the other end. So this has a fan, which is right at the end of the motor, that will actually suck air into the system, and that air will circulate in the body of the pump itself to cool it down. So no friction, cooled by air, and these rotary claws have the possibility to reach a vacuum up to 28 inches of mercury. They're available in four sizes: 30 CFM, 50 CFM, 80, and 100 CFM. There's two motor options with these pumps. Single phase, regular motors, turning at 3600 RPM, 5 horsepower, 7.5, and 10 horsepower. This particular model that you see here uses a three-phase motor. Three-phase motor has the possibility to feature variable rotation. And the variable rotation is achieved with the help of a drive system here, with the help of a sensor in the manifold of your releaser. It's gonna read the vacuum constantly. So you put a set point on the vacuum you wanna get, let's say 26, and the system will revolve for you to maintain that 26 inches of mercury. And what's particular with Bosch pumps is that they can achieve high vacuum even at low revolution. So basically what a drive system does, it's telling you how good you are managing your leaks in your woods. So the slower it goes, the less leaks you have in your woods. So it basically tells you that you got some work to do, or you can sit and relax because you've done your job managing your leaks. Just to show you, we'll kick it in, raises the vacuum on the gauge over there, and when it reaches the set point, you see it slowing down right now, but still capable of maintaining high vacuum at low revolution. So it has also an effect on, of course, electrical consumption. The slower it goes, the less electricity it takes. And the less wear also, you know, of the gearbox and the motor when it turns more slow. The pump features also a few controls that could be linked to the drive. A thermostat for your auto start and auto stop with a set point that you determine. The humidity trap also, which features a switch connected also to the drive for emergency stop in case of a misfunction of the releaser. All Bosch pumps also features a inlet filter, which is pretty much the same as a car engine filter, as well as a lubrication valve here. It's recommended at every 75 to 100 hours of functioning to have like an ounce and a half of automatic transmission fluid that is entered by this valve here directly into the pump, so it's going to lubricate the moving parts of the rotary claws. For it's a coating for protection against rust and also helps cleaning the pump. Any Bosch pump has to be protected for flooding of the releaser. If water gets up to the pump will be stopped by a humidity trap. Here we feature a Bernard humidity trap, which has a little switch that is triggered by a float, so to avoid water to get right to the pump. So the way it works, it fills, goes to a certain level, and makes the pump to stop totally. And when the pump is stopped, vacuum is released, and then the canister will empty itself, and the float will go down, and the pump will fall. As you can see, Bosch vacuum pumps are capable of reaching high vacuum, up to 27.5, or a maximum of 28.4. So, with the help of the potential